Hi everyone, my name is Anthony Fontana. I'm an IRS enrolled agent with EA Tax Resolutions, and today I'm gonna let you know what tax documents you will need when it comes to tax time for homeowners. All right, so we're jumping right in here. This is what we call the IRS Form 1098 Mortgage Interest Statement. This is issued to you by your mortgage lender, and they should issue this to you by January 31st. So you have that in time to prepare your tax return. Now, key points here is box one, the amount of mortgage interest that you've paid to your lender, and you're going to be able to use this as an itemized deduction. Other key points is box five, the amount of mortgage insurance premiums you've paid. You may be able to use this as an itemized deduction. There's certain limitations here, but regardless, you know, you can use that box, as well as box six here, points paid on purchase of your principal residence. Again, you may be able to use this as an itemized deduction as well. Now, another key thing here is, you know, if you're paying your property taxes through escrow, your mortgage lender will most likely include the amount of property taxes you've paid here on box 10, and it'll give a little description. It'll say like property taxes paid and the amount you've paid for the year. So if you've never seen this form before, you know, just make sure you're on the lookout here for this form before you go ahead and prepare your return, as it can be very beneficial on your tax return. All right, so now that we know what the Form 1098 looks like, I'm gonna go through a list of other tax documents for homeowners. So number two I have here on my list is property tax payments. You're gonna need to gather all the payments you've made in the current year for property taxes, so we can use that on the itemized schedule along with the mortgage interest on that 1098. Okay, so number three I have is DMV Registration Bill. So this is obviously not just for homeowners, but it does go on that itemized schedule along with the property taxes and the mortgage interest. And we're gonna need the actual bill because it does itemize the different fees that you are paying for, which some are tax deductible and some are not. So we will need that DMV registration bill for tax time. Number four, again, not just for homeowners, but for the itemized schedule, the charitable contributions. So anything you're given to Goodwill, Salvation Army, the church, any nonprofit organization, gather all those receipts together so we can use that amount as an itemized deduction along with the DMV registration bill, the property tax, and the mortgage interest. Number five is just kind of generic. You're gonna need to get the W-2s and 1099s issued to you so we can report the income on those forms. So this list over here is just strictly for homeowners, but not frequently used as often or seen as much, at least in my practice. However, just as important, so you can make sure that we get all the deductions possible. So number six I have here is the settlement statement or the closing statement for purchasing your home. Now, we're gonna use this only in the first year after you purchased the home, just to reconcile the amounts on that statement to that 1098 mortgage interest statement to make sure we're not missing any deductions that you're entitled for. Number seven I have here is receipts from qualified energy efficiency improvements. All right, so that's a mouthful. So what these are basically anything that help with the energy efficiency in your house. So whether that be qualified windows, heating, air conditioning, insulation, there's a whole host of different products that qualify for this. Now you're gonna know when you purchase one of these products that it does qualify for this tax credit, because that's one of the selling points that the company that sells you these products is gonna use. So just be sure to keep those receipts for tax time so we can make sure we claim those tax credits. Number eight is the mortgage credit certificate. Again, another one of those things that you know you're gonna be receiving, because when you are applying for your loan or your mortgage for your house, this is one of the selling points that the lender is going to offer, is to get this tax credit. Now, certain people qualify for this, and you're gonna know that you qualify for this when you do. Just make sure that when it comes tax time, we grab that certificate so we can make sure that we get that tax credit. Number nine does not have to do with the current year tax return. However, it does have to do when we sell the home. So this is something that we're gonna need to keep record of, and that's home improvement receipts. So these are home improvements that are not the qualified energy efficiency improvements.
Now, those may be, you know, a redoing of the roof, a renovation of the bathroom. You may be doing new floors in your house, anything like that. You're gonna wanna make sure you keep the receipts for not only the materials, but also the construction costs. So when you go to sell the home, you're not gonna be paying tax on the full gain from just, you know, the cost to the sales price. You're gonna be able to add the amounts that you're paying for those home improvements to your cost, so the gain is less, i.e. the tax is less. So be sure to keep those receipts and keep good records. Now, I hope this video was helpful for you guys. If you can, please like, share, or subscribe to my channel. If you have any other ideas for tax videos you think I can do, please leave those in the comment section below. Thank you so much.